Tejin here. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can take an image and convert it into a dancing character and create something exciting like this. Learn how to chroma key your videos and create your own exciting viral video for 100% free using Viggle AI and Capcut. It's super easy and fun and a great way to create viral content. If you like this sort of content, make sure to subscribe to this channel. Let's dive right in. To get started, open up a browser and go to lexica.art. Lexica is your typical text-to-image generator, but here you can search for any type of user-generated images and use them for free. I love Pixar characters, so I'm going to search for female character Pixar and hit search. Instantly, I get a ton of awesome images to choose from. Just scroll through the page until you find something just right. Actually, let me scroll back up a bit. This one. Let me click on the image. I think she'll look perfect in my Viggle animated music video. Click the down arrow button to download it. Now with the character downloaded, we need a background image. In the search box, type in the background you want to use in your video. I'm going to search for living room Pixar style and hit search. And instantly, I get a ton of background images to choose from. I'm going to scroll down until something just pops out in front of me. This one. Let me check out some of the variations. I like this one best, so I'm going to download this image. Now with all our images downloaded, let's go to Viggle.ai. Viggle is your next generation AI video generator that's currently free. If you never tried Viggle before, click on the link that's popping up on top. Now before we start animating, we're going to need 3 motion templates that will animate our images. Click on prompt. Motion templates are preset templates that allow us to easily animate our characters in the same style. I'm going to search for the first prompt that would go well in my Pixar dance video. The crisscross prompt looks pretty good to me. Let me copy the prompt. Let's go back to Viggle AI and click join the beta if you haven't done so. Once you're in their Discord, click on any of the animate channels to start generating. In the prompt box, type /animate and hit enter. Upload your character image. Now paste in the crisscross motion template prompt in the motion prompt box. For background, it's important to click on green because I'm going to show you how to use a tool called chroma key. And for fine tune, always choose on. And hit enter. Now I want to add 2 more dance moves using the same character, so I'm going to repeat this process 2 more times. I'll use the bobbing motion prompt, then animate it on Viggle using the animate tool. I'll search for 1 more motion prompt. I'll choose the where is Matt motion prompt, then animate it on Viggle. It only takes 1 to 2 minutes to generate your videos. So search for your generated videos and download it. Now with all our videos downloaded, let's go create our video. Go to CapCut.com. You'll need the CapCut video editor, which is probably one of the best free video editors on the market. You'll have the option of using the web version or download their Windows app. Click sign up for free to get started. With CapCut open, click import to upload your image and video assets. We need to first set the background, so click and drag your background image into a timeline. Let's set the aspect ratio of the video by clicking on ratio. I'll choose a 16:9 ratio for a landscape video. Click and drag the corner of the image until it fits perfectly into the video frame, and make some minor adjustments. Perfect. Now let's drag and drop our first dancing character into the timeline. Let's use the chroma key function to create a transparent background. Click cut out, then click the chroma key option. Use the color picker tool to select the green area on the video. This will make the background transparent. Increase the strength to around 34 to make the edges a bit more smoother. To get rid of the Viggle logo, click the auto cutout option to leave the character and remove everything else. Click and drag the image to adjust the size and placement in the video. Click adjustment and click on the auto adjust option to auto adjust the color and tone of your character. Now to remove the music in the background, right click on the video and click extract audio. This will extract the audio from the video and click on the audio frame and hit the delete button. Let me extend the length of the background image in the video to around 50 seconds by dragging the right end of the video frame to the right. Now to extend the length of the character video, you can copy and paste the current video frame or click on the video, hold the alt key button and click and drag the video to the right to make a copy. Make sure to align it perfectly to the left side of the original video. Perfect. Now with the first character in place, let's drag and drop our second character. Now you'll want to repeat the same steps we used for the first character. Use the chroma key tool to remove the green screen. Use the auto cutout to remove the Viggle logo. Set the chroma key strength to 34. Now click and drag your character into position. Click the auto adjust option under adjustments. Extend the video length by making a copy of the video and aligning it with the original video. Remove the music with the Extract Auto option. Click Delete. Now repeat the same process for the third character. Now with all our characters in position, let's add in some effects. Click on Effects and choose the Trending category. I'm going to drag and drop the Tracking Shot 2 effect to give my video a constant camera movement effect. Drag the right end of the effects frame to the right to increase the length of the effect. The second effect I want to use is the flickery shots, which basically gives the video a popping flickery effect. I'll place it over the timeline where the video frames connect to cover up minor inconsistencies in the transitions. Now we can add in the music. Click on the audio option and under music, search for the music you want. I want to use EDM music, so I'm going to search EDM. I'll go with the first one. Click and drag the music file into the timeline. Now I want my characters to appear each time the melody repeats in the music. So I'll find a part where the melody repeats and drag the second character's video to align with that time frame. Now to make the character magically appear in the video, let's add an opacity keyframe. Click on the video and make sure to align the playhead to the beginning of the video. Hit the arrow key on the keyboard 12 times to move the playhead 12 microseconds to the right. Now under the video option, click on Blend. And on the opacity row, click on the diamond shape button to add an opacity keyframe to our video. Then click on the video and click back to the beginning of the video. Now in the opacity option, set the opacity toggle to the left to set it to 0% opacity. Now she transitions nicely into the video at the beginning of the melody. Let's do the same for the third character. Find when the melody starts again for the third time. Align the third character to the playhead. Add the opacity keyframe to the third video. Okay, everything is now set. You can make final adjustments to the video by extending the length of the video. Use the Delete Right tool to trim off excess parts of each video asset. I'm going to add some more flickery effects to the video. Once you're done making any final adjustments, we need to set the in and out points of the video. This basically sets what part of the video we want to export. Move the playhead to the part of the video where you want it to end and hit the O button to set it as the out point. This will automatically set the beginning of the video as the in point. Now we're ready to export the video. Click on the export button, input the title of your video, and hit export. Now you're ready to create your own video. If you thought that was fun, then you need to check out this video.